Hello all, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In my previous video, I had explained about the significance of period statuses for GL and AP module, and in my current video, I'll explain about the significance of the period status for the AR module. So these are the different statuses of periods in AR module: not open, future interval, open, close, pending, and close. Now let me explain in detail the significance of these period statuses and what kind of transactions can be entered when a period falls in any of these period statuses. So the first status is not opened. So when a period is not open status, so obviously as the period is not open, you will not be able to enter any kind of transaction, whether it be a creation of an invoice or a debit memo or creation of the receipt or creation of the receipt reversal. And as you are not able to enter any transaction under a period which is in not open, obviously the system will not allow any create accounting and transfer to GL for that particular transactions in that particular period. Of course, there will not be any transactions. And the next status is the future interval status. If the period is in future interval period, future interval status, then you can enter a transaction, but you cannot do a create accounting or transfer to GL. As far as the going back to the previous status is concerned, once the period is in future interval status, you cannot go back to the not opened status or the previous status. So let me show this in the system. So you should have logged into AR responsibility. So now I'm currently in accounts receivable super user responsibility. Navigate to control, accounting, open close periods. So here you can see the different periods. So I can see even the periods which are in not open status. So I can see only the periods up to June 2020, because in my calendar only the periods up to June 2020 are defined. So put your cursor here and click on the drop down in the not open. So once it is in not open status, either you can go to open or future interval. So if you click on the drop down, even though it shows the other statuses like closed and closed pending, if you try to select say closed and click on say okay, you get an message saying that you cannot change the period status from not open to closed. So ideally, if the period is in not open status, you should actually change it to future or open status. And if the period is in future interval, you cannot go back to the not open. So let me put my cursor in future. Again, even though in the drop down it shows not open, if I try to select this and try to save this, it will throw an error message saying that you cannot change the period status from future to not open. So you can change the status from future to open, but not to not open. So let me click on open. Status to be changed from future to open. And if the period is in open status, yes, you can enter any kind of transaction. You can do a create accounting transfer to GL. And again, you cannot go back to the future or non-enterable status. So let me put my cursor here. Even though again, it shows in the drop-down, if I try to select future, save this, it will throw an error message. Similarly, from open to not opened, save this. Again, you get an error message. So I'm still not sure as to why Oracle is actually allowing those period status to be shown in the dropdown. In the case of GL or your AP, depending on the period status, in the dropdown, it shows only the appropriate and the valid status. But unfortunately in AR, it is showing even all the invalid period status also in the dropdown. Of course, there is a control wherein system will not allow you to go back to those status. So in this example, it will not allow you to move from open to future or non-open status. But ideally, the form should have actually given us the functionality wherein it should have shown only the valid statuses. Anyways, and the next status is the close pending status. So when the period is in open status, you can actually change the status from open to closed or close pending. It's not mandated that you need to go to close pending and then close. You can directly go to the closed status. But the reason why Oracle has actually given this particular functionality of close pending is in AR, whenever you try to change status of the period from open to close, it is going to cross check if there is any kind of an unposted entries or any other kind of a accounting issues. If there are any accounting issues, it will not allow the period to be closed unless until that particular those issues are actually fixed. But come say month end, you are on the last working day of the month, you want to close the period, but there are some issues with the data wherein you need to raise an SR with Oracle, and Oracle will take maybe a couple of days to fix them. So in those scenarios, you can change the status of the period from open to close pending. If it is in close pending, system will not allow any new transactions to be entered, but it will allow you to put the status in close pending so that user cannot enter any kind of transaction, and also it's technically not clearly closed. So once you get a kind of a say data fix from Oracle, you change the status, you apply the data fix, and then change the status of the period from close pending to close status. Of course, if you want to again apply a data fix and run create accounting, you can change the status from close pending to open, run the create accounting, and then change status again back to close status. So close status is the last status. Once your period is in close, again, system will not allow any transactions to be entered, any create accounting or transfer to GL. But again, you can go back to the previous status. Again, if it is in close status, again, you can go back to close pending or open status. So this is a good thing with the close pending. So in the case of close pending, system will not check if there are any kind of an exception. It will just change the status from open to closed. But if you try to change the status from open to closed, system is going to cross check if there are any unposted entries. And if there are any unposted entries, it will not allow you to change the status from open to closed. So let me see my current case. Let me just go back to some old period. I don't know if there are any pending status, pending transactions, but let me try to change the status to say closed. Save this. See, when I'm trying to change the status from open to closed, I get a message saying that please wait checking for unposted entries. So when I click on OK, it says that you must post all transactions in this particular period before you close it. See, as there are some kind of an unposted transaction, system is not allowing me to close the period. So the status is still open. But I still want the period to be, I still do not want the users to enter any transactions in the particular period. So what I can do is, I can change the status from open to close pending. So basically, there are some, it was throwing an error message saying that there's a kind of an unposted transaction. But even though you run your create accounting and transfer to GL, but still if you are not able to push those transactions to GL because of some kind of a orphan records or some kind of a data inconsistency or some kind of a data corruption, then you need to raise an SR with Oracle, and Oracle will take its own time to provide us a data fix. But the users cannot wait. Hence, in those scenarios, you can change the status from open to close pending. See, now when I try to change the status, that's it. It's not even checking if there are any kind of a unposted or unaccounted transaction. Again, now I can change it back to from closed. If I try to change it back from closed to close pending, again, it's going to perform the same kind of a validations. So from close pending, I can go back to open, fix those issues, and then change the status to open to closed in this example. Okay. Thank you. Thanks for watching my video. For interesting videos on Oracle Financials, please do subscribe to my channel. Thank you.